Hello everyone, I am K. Narasimhamurthy, working as an assistant professor in the Government First Grade Women's College, Tumkur. Today I am going to present the video for the course BSc and the subject is Physics. The topic which I am discussing today is in the paper Semiconductor Devices, Digital Electronics, Laser and Fiber Optics. And the topic is solving the problems related to the digital electronics by SOP method and also by Karnoff map method. This syllabus is for the fifth semester students and it's for the Tumkur University. Today we are going to learn about the problem solving skills by SOP method and also problem solving using Karnoff map method. Now, the first problem which I am going to present here is the conversion of truth table into a logical circuit using SOP method. SOP in a sense, sum of product method. There is a procedure for that. If this truth table is given for us, how to convert a given truth table into a logical circuit by SOP method? The first step is identify the input variables for which the output is 1. So identify the output 1s and write down the min term, write down the product term for those combinations for which output is 1. So this is the combination 0, 0, 1 for which the output is 1. If I write a min term for that, it will be A bar dot B bar dot C. A bar is because A is 0. If the variable is 0, write it in a complemented form. If the variable is 1, input variable is 1, write it in a normal form. Look at here, C is 1. So C need not to be complemented. It has to be written as such in a normal form. So another output 1 combination is 0, 1, 0. For this, if I write a min term, it will be A bar dot B dot C bar. Another combination for which output is 1 is 0, 1, 1, for which the min term is, the product term is A bar B C. Another combination and the min term for that is A dot B dot C. So I have got the min terms for output 1s, for the combinations of input which produces the output 1s. So after getting the product terms, after getting the min terms, now the thing is to sum all the min terms or R all the min terms. It's a logical summing. You have to do the logical summing. After doing that, you will get an equation, very big equation, Y is equal to sum all these things. A bar B bar C plus A bar B C plus A bar B C bar plus A B C. That is the logical final equation we can produce from the truth table by SOP method. After getting an equation, it's a very simple to build a logical circuit which suits that equation. Now we have to produce this logic circuits. So we need a 4 input OR gate here. And to produce A bar B bar C, we need an AND gate here. So we require 4 AND gates and 1 OR gate. Of course, to make A bar and B bar, we require a NOT gate. So we require a 3 NOT gates for the 3 inputs. Okay. So A bar, it's A, B, C is given to the AND gate. Output will be A dot B dot C. If A bar, B bar, C is given to the another AND gate, it will be A bar, B bar, C. Another is A bar, B, C. Another is this. If the 4 outputs of AND gates is given to the input of 4 input OR gate, so the output will be this equation. Output will be our final equation. So that is the way, that is how we can build a logical circuits using this SOP method. Now, there is a different kind of method to solve these kind of equations, to solve these kind of truth tables, and that is Karnoff map method. Before going to the problems, we should understand what is Karnoff map is. Karnaugh map is a virtual display of fundamental products. These fundamental products are needed for SOP solution. To write an SOP equation, to write in canonical SOP form, we need to find out the fundamental products. These fundamental products are minterms are displayed virtually by this Karnaugh map. So overall, the Karnaugh map, or it's simply called as K-map. K-map is a virtual display of these fundamental products which needed for SOP equation. Now the thing is how to construct this Karnaugh map. I'll tell you step by step to how to construct this K-maps. The first step is the vertical column. I'm discussing only the two variable inputs here, A and B. We'll move on to the three variable input after this. Vertical column has A bar followed by A, and the horizontal row has B bar followed by B. That's the first step. First, the given Karnaugh map has columns and rows. The columns are A bar A and rows are B bar B. Okay, right. Now identify the input combinations for which output is 1. That is the second step. Identifying the input combinations for which output is 1. After identifying the combinations, put 1s in blanks of K-map respective to the minterm. So we have identified 1s and we have written the minterms. For that minterms, write 1 in the K-map and put 0s in the remaining blank. With an example, if I can teach you better, I'll take an example. So this is the example of two variable K-maps. This is the truth table given for us. Now the assigned work is to build a Karnaugh map for this truth table. Okay, we'll do that. We'll follow the procedure one by one and build the Karnaugh map for that. The first step is identify. First, we'll understand this Karnaugh map. The structure of this Karnaugh map is the columns are A bar A, okay, and rows are B bar B. It's only two variable Karnaugh map, so only it's a very simple thing. Columns will be A bar A and rows will be B bar B. The first step is to identify the combinations for which output is 1. Look here, this output 1 and this combination is 1, 0. Another combination for which output is 1 is 1, 1. So this 1, 1 has an output 1. So after identifying the combinations of input for which output is 1, write the minterm. So minterm will be A dot B bar, and for this is A dot B. First step is over. Now the thing is, put 1s in the black respective to the minterm. Okay, fine. The first minterm is A B bar. Look at the A B bar box. This is A and this is B bar, and the box which is related to A B bar is this. For this box, put 1. Second minterm is A B. Find out the box which gives you A B. Here is A, here is B, and the box is this. Put 1 in the box respective to the minterm. We have two minterms, so for the two box you have to put 1. After putting 1, put zeros in the remaining box. For this, there are two remaining box. Put 0 for this and put 0 for this. Okay, so our Karnaugh map is ready. K map is ready for this given truth table. That is how a K map can be constructed. We move on to the three variable Karnaugh map. Here, the vertical columns is a little complicated thing here. The vertical columns is start with a A bar, B bar, and the next is A bar, A, B, and next is A, B, and next is A, B bar. Just like how I written A bar A for the two input variables, we have four combinations for the three input variables. And horizontal row will be labeled as C bar C. Okay, So after labeling all this, first thing is put ones in the k-map respective to the minterm, okay, and enter zeros in the remaining box, just exactly how we did for the two input variable Karnaugh map, exactly the same way we are doing it here. But a thing is, we have an extra boxes here, we have an extra rows and extra columns here. When we look at this k-map, you will understand things better. This is the given truth table for us, okay. Now the thing is, we have to construct a Karnaugh map for this truth table, okay. Yes, it's a simple work, it's a simple thing. First thing, rows, as we know, C bar C, rows in the Karnaugh map is C bar C, and the columns in the Karnaugh map is A bar B bar, A bar B, and A B, and A B bar. Now the columns are fixed and rows are fixed. Now the next is to identify the input combinations for which output is 1. I'm getting only 3 ones here in the output. I'm getting only 3 input combinations. One is 0, 1, 0. For this 0, 1, 0, if I write a minterm, it will be A bar, B, C bar. For another input combination is 1, 1, 0. If I write a minterm, it will be A, B, C bar. Another combination is A, B, C. So totally I'm getting a 3 combinations of input for which the output is 1. I'm getting a 3 minterms here. For these 3 minterms, put 1 in the respective box. So the first minterm which I'm getting is A bar B C. A bar B C, put 1. No, it is for A bar B C bar. A bar B C bar, we are putting 1 here. Another is A, B, C bar. A, B, C bar, I'm putting 1 here. And for A, B, C, I'm putting 1 here. In rest of the boxes, put 0. We are left with totally 5 boxes now. So put 0 in the remaining 5 boxes. So our K map is ready. Karnaugh map is ready. That is the procedure. That is how we can create a Karnaugh map with the given truth table. We can create a 2-input Karnaugh map and also a little complicated 3-input Karnaugh map. That can also be done. Yes. Now, we learned how to make a Karnaugh map, how to construct a Karnaugh map, but still we are not learned how to simplify, how to get a logical equation from the truth table. There is a procedure for that. And the principle which we are going to use for simplification using Karnaugh map is the grouping. Grouping is used for simplification. How the things are grouped? Adjacent cell having ones are grouped. After writing a Karnaugh map, adjacent cells having ones are grouped. How we are going to group this? Grouping is done in such a way to get pair in a sense, 2 adjacent cells, and a quad in a sense, 4 adjacent cells, and an actant in the sense, 8 adjacent cells. Okay, right. That is the way we have to group the things in the Karnaugh map. Right. This is the procedure for simplification. Okay. So I'll start from the beginning. So enter ones on the Karnaugh map for each fundamental product that produce one output in the truth table. I enter zero elsewhere. Okay, that's a known thing. We know how to construct a Karnaugh map. After constructing the Karnaugh map, now the thing is grouping. Encircle the groups, encircle the adjacent group which produce pairs, quads, actants. Okay, pair in the sense 2, quads in the sense 4, actant in the sense 8. Okay, now the thing is, we have to encircle the groups, encircle the actants, encircle the quads, encircle the pairs if any. And you can roll these things, and if there is overlapping is there, you find out the overlappings. Finally, the thing is, you have to get a largest group possible. You make rolling, you make overlapping. So finally, you should get a largest group possible. After getting a largest group possible, if any isolated one still remains, encircle that. And if any redundant group is there, you eliminate the redundant group, unwanted group. Write the Boolean equation by opening the products corresponding to the encircled group. Only you have to look at the encircled group. For that encircled group, write a Boolean equation. Okay, but this is actually the procedure which we have to follow to simplify this truth table into a logical circuit or a Boolean equation. With an example, these things are very much clear. Now I have taken a first example. I have already written a Karnaugh map. This is two input Karnaugh map which I have already written. I got this 1 1, two adjacent ones. This is a pair because two ones makes a pair. So thing is to encircle these pairs. Encircle the pair. Okay. After encircling, write an equation. How to write an equation? Okay. See this pair which includes A bar A. A bar A will be 1. Okay. A bar plus A will be 1. Multiplied with a B here. Okay. So if A bar A will be 1 with a B here, it will give you B, just B. Okay. So output equation will be just B here for the first example. Look at the second example. I have already written a Karnaugh map. I have already constructed a Karnaugh map. Now the thing is to simplify and to get a logical equation. We have four adjacent ones here. Okay. So group the four adjacent ones. It makes a quad. Okay. So encircle the quad. After encircling, you have to write an equation. Now how to write an equation? Here it is A bar B and AB. A bar B and AB, A bar B plus AB. You can take out A bar plus A, one group. A bar plus A will be 1. We left with only B. Okay. These two, we left with only B here. And here, C bar plus C. C bar plus C will be 1. Here we left with only B. Here we left with only 1. So 1 into B will be B. So finally, the output logic equation for this Karnaugh map will be Y is equal to B. Very simple one. Very simple one. We move on to the next thing. This example includes all the things. Okay. I have taken the four input variables A, B, C, D, and our Karnaugh map will be little complicated. Okay, so I have already constructed a Karnaugh map. I have written ones respective to the minterm and I have put the zeros in the remaining boxes. After constructing the Karnaugh map, the first procedure is grouping. Group the adjacent things, adjacent ones has to be grouped. Here if I group, I'll get a pair. This I'll group, I'll get a quad, four ones. And this if I group, I'll get another quad, four adjacent ones. So grouping is done. I have added three groups, two quads and one pair. After doing grouping, you need to write a logical equation. So one by one, we'll write a logical equation for this pair. For this pair 1, 1, I'll write a logical equation. Here it is C bar D and this is C D. I'll take a D common factor out of it. C bar plus C will becomes 1. I am left with a D here. This rows I'll come. It is A bar B bar. A bar B bar into D. Okay. So with pair represents A bar B bar D. The pair is over. Next, go to the first quad, lower quad. This quad, okay, A bar B plus AB. B as common factor, it will be A plus A bar. Now, we left with only B here. Similarly, if I do it for these two combinations, if I take C bar as a common factor, we left with a D bar D, which is 1. And this gives C bar and this gives B. Now, the thing is B dot C bar. This quad stands for B dot C bar. Look at the last quad, which is in the right hand side. If I do the simplification, here these two, okay, if I take A bar as a common factor, it will be B bar B. If I take A common factor, it will be B bar B. So overall, this thing will be 1. Overall thing for these four will be 1. We left with only this thing here, C D bar. C D bar multiplied by 1 will be C D bar. So overall 3 I got, 1 from pair and 2 from the two quads. Now the thing is to sum all these things to the logical addition. So the first is A bar B bar D plus A C bar plus C D bar. Okay. So that is how we can simplify a given truth table using Karnaugh map. So these are some of the reference book which I have referred. These are really good books. You please refer Malvino and Leach, which is that with the title Digital Principle and Applications. It's a very old book, but it's a really good book. And also some of the aspects are given in the College Physics by Sundar Rajan. It's a really good book. And you are with the internet also, you can get many number of sources, enough of sources. You keep on practicing the constructing of Karnaugh map and simplifying that given truth table using this KMAF method. I hope you understand my class. Thank you very much.